Hello everyone, this is Suman Deep on behalf of Seabird, and it's been a long time that I'm working with Seabird, and today we are here. The session of the day is about general task 1, that is a letter. And in today's class I will discuss a few tips that will help you to improve and get more scores in task 1 GT. There are a few things which we need to do when we begin the task, when we begin writing it. First thing, we need to read the scenario very carefully. This is how this helps us to understand it more, as well as to attempt the right task. It prevents you writing off topic. First of all, you must read the scenario and then understand it. You may read it twice as well. It hardly takes 30 seconds. Then you must plan it, that you must plan what reason you are going to write, what suggestion you are going to write, to whom you are going to write, and kind of vocabulary you are going to use in your answer. And then you should start writing. It helps you to maybe writing it well as in an appropriate answer. So first thing, when you start writing, you must take care that you must clear all the bullet points which are given in the scenario, in the statement to you. That is really very important. When you start, when you open your letter, there are three options that you can use while signing to someone, that is Mr., Mrs. or Miss. This one is for male members, and both of the options are for females. When you know you are sure that one is married, you can use Mrs. Otherwise, you can use Ms. as well. Then, if you are doing the casual opening, the casual letters can be opened with dear friend or dear and name of your friend as well, as in dear John, dear Annie, something like that. Some standard expressions that signifies your formal and casual letters. In formal letters, my vocabulary changes. There is different kind of words which we always write for the formal readings. In formal, there is one example that I have given here. Like in formal, if whenever I am apologizing about something, in my formal letter, my language would be something like, my sincere apologies for missing the meeting. And the same thing if I'm writing to a friend, maybe it is a casual, there is some casual thing and I want to apologize for that. I would directly say I am sorry for not attending the wedding or not attending the party. So I believe this will help you understanding the difference between formal and casual vocabulary which we use, and I hope it will help you more to improve your writings and you will get good scores. I think that's all for today's class. In future, we'll be there soon with another information, with another sessions of IELTS as well as other courses. If you want another information, you can join our classes. And I think it's time to say goodbye and stay tuned on Seabird International.